So the big story, or one of the big stories last week, was about Kennedy Adjapong, who is behind me. You can see his photograph in there. Now, he had made some remarks, uncomplimentary, very derogatory remarks about the Electoral Commissioner, the Honorable Charlotte Osei. And he suggested, for instance, that Madam Osei did not get her job meritoriously, as it ought to be and as everyone believed. He made suggestions without backing them with any allegations, and he actually said unprintable words against the Electoral Commissioner. Since then, Kennedy Adjapong has come under fire. This will not be the first time that he's come under fire for one thing or the other, but he has come under real fire in this regard, and also because of the personalities who have advanced the consent against Kennedy Adjapong. What we'd like to do tonight will be attempting to locate the problem and also to deposit the responsibility as to how, as a nation, we can resolve some of these matters. We are offering a humble suggestion as our editorial team in this editorial, especially to the Minister for Gender and Social Protection, Oye Lithur, whom we know well, who's appeared on our program several times, and who has actually been doing an excellent job. Recently, she was awarded for being the minister with the best social media interactive page, and that's very true. We congratulate Madam Oye Lithur for that. But Madam Oye Lithur led the charge against Kennedy Adjapong. Now, we want to put this in some perspective. So, Kennedy Adjapong spoke about the Electoral Commissioner, Madam Charlotte Osei, and then other people were worried about it. And then the gender minister also spoke. So, when the gender minister spoke, he asked Kennedy Adjapong to apologize. But here is where we are. We are a few months to an election, and campaign is going to start. And we will be seeing, we hope we don't see a lot of these things. So our focus tonight is to suggest to you, Madam Oye Lithur, that if you can make some recommendations about a general rule and make those recommendations to the institutions of parliament, make those recommendations to the National Media Commission, so that if a member of parliament, and there will be about 500 to 600 people who will be competing for parliament in this election, all of them will be campaigning, there are women in there, they'll be saying things about them, and we don't like what they say about our women. We are urging you, Madam Oye Lithur, the Honorable Oye Lithur, to make recommendations to parliament as to how members of parliament or prospective members of parliament can be dealt with, and also make recommendations to the National Media Commission as to how the National Media Commission should handle those press houses that actually amplify some of these unprintable words in manners that that deepen the derogatory color of the statements that are made. Because there are some media houses that will discuss it only to bring it up and to criticize the speaker, as is being done to Kennedy Adjapong, which is great. But there are also some media houses that will amplify it only just to enhance and make worse the derogatory nature of the accusation. So the National Media Commission, perhaps, Madam Oye Lithur, you can help us to make recommendations to the National Media Commission, and also make recommendations to Parliament, and general recommendations to the people of Ghana, because you stand in a very critical position, and it's exciting that you are at this time in charge of this job, because we know that Oye Lithur, ever since her practice at law, and those of us who have been covering journalism, covering stories as journalists for a very long time, I've covered Oye Lithur for nearly 20 years. She started her career as a brave young lawyer who was daring even to talk about gender issues in those days. In the late 90s, people didn't talk about gender issues, but Oye Lithur did. She worked for FIDA in those days with Gloria Feribuedu. And I suppose that even during her practice at the law trust firm, I doubt whether, Madam Oye Lithur, whether you actually took up a case that did not have to do with social protection, that did not have to do with something that you could not benefit from. And so you remember that I used to come to your office at the law trust firm and look at what you were doing. Almost always, Oye Lithur and Gloria Feribuedu and their team will be doing legal practice in favor of people, either pro bono cases. So she's been in this space for a very long time, and it is just appropriate that she becomes the gender minister. At this time, I think that you can do the nation a great lot of good, if I can say that, by sort of bringing us a basis of how you think these matters should be dealt with. And you are familiar with best practices across the country and across the world, and so you can bring us some of those best practices. I'm worried and saying this to you, Madam Oye Lithur, because if you look at the subsequent conversations that have occurred after you led a charge against Kennedy Adjapong, some of it speaks to selective sort of attack. Some of it speaks to a certain dishonesty, quote and unquote, I should say. And it's all not helpful for our society. And in this editorial, over the next 5 minutes, I'll be giving examples of some of these things that have happened, that you are being accused of having been silent. If, for instance, in this nation, Ghana, this small country, as gender minister, you lead a charge against Kennedy Adjapong, and you have a response from an Esla Owusu, who is a member of parliament for the Dansoman constituency. I'll get the real name later. And who responds to you like this on social media? We have to be terribly worried in this country. Now, here is what Esla Owusu said. She said, in response especially to the post put up by Oye Lithur, she said, "Oh, I just remember that when I was physically attacked and brutalized at Ododododio, some of those wailing today said I deserved it. Their favorite quote was, all slap be slap. As for being accused of prostitution for post, Matia te ate ate abre from both NDC and MPP people. Hypocrites," she says. Okay, back to no comments, lip sealed, just pissed off. Now, if we have that kind of comment coming from an honorable member of parliament in response to what you are doing in terms of isolating Kennedy Adjapong for attack, which is fair, I think, Madam Oye Lithur, we have to have another thinking. We have to have a rethink of this process, of how we can create standards. And we are going into an election. Media are going to be covering it. People are going to talk about it. Baba Jamal is already being accused of saying something derogatory against a woman who is competing against him in Akwetia constituency. And we have had history of these things. The one that was very disturbing, which I didn't hear, and correct me if I'm wrong, Madam Oye Lithur talk about, was Efia Pokua. Efia Pokua of Adom FM, once or twice he's been on our TV station, was brutalized by officials of the National Health Insurance Authority, or people who represented those officials somewhere in Accra. And when the matter was put up, there were comments on social media, she talks too much, in Akan to which they say Nanuya Dindodo, in Ghan to which they say Nawachon. And she was brutally assaulted, physically, verbally. Nothing was done because there are no standards to protect women who get into these public work services. And yes, men may need protection, but women need more protection. And we have to admit that. Nobody said much about Efia Pokua. This week, she has got a vindication from the law courts. She had to go to the law courts because she trusted in her case. And congratulations to you, Samson Ladia Ayeneni, for leading that charge. They went to the law court, and Efia Pokua got vindicated after the matter was ventilated by the court. They thought that she had been abused. There were no standards. No one said anything. She was brutalized. Of course, we also have... We remember when Professor Mills became president, the learned Chief Justice, Georgina Wood. Georgina Wood was frantically attacked by the association calling itself Association for Accountable Governance. It was led by Dr. Clementa Park, who is today a presidential staffer and who is also the NDC Member of Parliament for Bursa. Time after time, they mounted pressure on Georgina Wood. The excesses of the accountable governance attack was almost nearly insinuating that the Chief Justice, by her gender, had unmeritorious rights to the position of Chief Justice under Akufo's administration. They urged Professor Mills to remove the Chief Justice. Alhaji Bature was part of that group as well. And they seem to have urged Professor Mills to remove the Chief Justice until the learned professor made a clear public statement that she was not about to take out the Chief Justice because there were no standards in the country, Madam Oye Lithur, to sort of tell us what we can do and what we cannot do, and standards that will be aimed at protecting women in public office. And we need to do that as a country, because the more women we have in public office, the more developed we'll be, and there's more than enough research and evidence to demonstrate that every developed country has women in key positions. And we need to encourage our women, especially coming from the culture that we are coming from. So it ought not just to be about Charlotte, Madame Charlotte Ose. And we regret the comments of Kennedy Adjapong. He has to be bastardized. He has to probably even to be resigned from parliament, as we can see what's happening around the world, where people are resigning at the least provocation, if you like. But this effort of fixing this problem, especially as we get into an election, we are suggesting on this editorial tonight that it has to be a well thought out effort. And we think that Oye Lithur is the best person, Madam Oye Lithur is the best person as gender and social protection minister, and also with the kind of background that Oye Lithur has in terms of intervening in social protection, even when there was no ministry for social protection, even when she was a private legal practitioner, Madam Oye Lithur used to do these things. We think it's time for her to be able to do that, not just attack candidates upon, but let's have the standard so that if Ifeapokua can feel protected, so that Esla Usu doesn't bring up a post on social media and says that, when it happened to me, no one said anything. In fact, people were supporting it. Now it's happened to somebody else and people are talking about it. So we've talked about Georgina Wood. Let's even talk about Betty Moldi Drisu. And I interviewed Madam Oye Lithur on this program at the time when the NDC contest for running mate in 2008 occurred. And I asked her who she was backing, whether President John Mahama, who was then a member of parliament, John Mahama, or she was backing Betty, and said she was backing Betty because Betty was a woman. It was a pleasurable interview she gave me at that time. When the Woyome issue occurred, the pressure that was laid on Betty Moore's shoulders, indicating and insisting that she had some compromise, she had compromised herself one way or the other as Attorney General to pay out those monies to Alfred Woyome. Many people insinuated many things. And one of the few platforms that supported Betty was this platform. Because we said that, well, Betty, there's no evidence that Betty has done something wrong. And women have to be protected in that area. In fact, she was our first female attorney general. And she had run into this difficulty. Eventually, the courts appeared to have cleared her just months ago. But Betty was attacked and attacked and attacked and lambasted. And as usual, when they attack you and you're a woman, they don't stop short of adding everything. All the derogatory sarcasm and utter nonsense about sexuality, it always comes up in politics. It always comes up in public service. Happened to Ifeapokua as a journalist, sexuality came up. It always comes up in our culture when a woman is being attacked for something. When a man is being attacked, they don't say that. But when a woman is being attacked, ultimately they will say it. Maybe the key protagonists don't say it. But the extra commentary that occurs around the matter, people continue to talk about it. And Betty herself was a victim of this. And Madam Betty Moldi Drisu this week has been in the forefront, joining the chorus against Kennedy Adjapong, which is great. But all we are saying to the Gender and Social Protection Minister is that what you can bequeath in your first term as minister as a wonderful legacy for this country is to give us a certain standard, code of ethics, practice about how women in public service can be protected. So that if people say something about a woman relating to sexuality, that person must be sanctioned a certain way. You can make recommendations to Parliament. You can make recommendations to the National Media Commission, because ultimately it's the media platforms that broadcast these things that then make it much more serious than it would have been. We know there's social media, but traditional media still holds the large numbers of the mass numbers to carry out information. So National Media Commission may get involved in that and say that if you're a media house and you broadcast this XYZ said about a woman, I nearly forgot one of them, the Honorable Alima Mahama. We remember her. When in 2008, Nana Akufo-Addo suggested that Alima could be his running mate and hopefully create the first female vice president in Ghana, all hell broke loose within the MPP. And as they talk and they talk and they talk, they come to sexuality. All the time, women are abused. Sexuality has to be part of it. Let's not single out this matter. Kennedy Adjapong must be taken to the cleaners, about Charlotte Ose. In fact, it was the same Kennedy Adjapong who also attacked Effia Schwarzenegger. The sitcom. She's a sitcom superstar, Effia Schwarzenegger. She was also attacked by Kennedy Adjapong. She was called a prostitute. It was said that she has HIV. A lot of things were said about her. There were no standards. Nobody said anything about it. So this is a call in our editorial today to the woman, the Minister for Gender and Social Protection, Madam Oye Lithur. Let's get these things working. Because if you speak the way you've spoken against Kennedy Adjapong, beautiful as it is, and upset and aggressive as you are, and you have Esla Owusu coming back with what she came back with and indicating that when she was attacked, no one said she's a member of parliament. And she was brutally attacked. She said she was slapped, she was beaten up. If Ifeapokua was slapped, beaten up, she had to go to the court and seek redress. And we know that you've been doing a lot of things, Madam Oye Lithur, but this particular one will be great because we are going into an election and people are going to be attacked. And when it's a woman, they always get to sexuality. We believe that you heard our message, and those of you who agree with us, let us know that you agree with us as you watch this video also on social media. And Madam Oye Lithur, we will wait to hear from you. But for now, we think that the ball is firmly in your court. Do something, as they say, before you die.
Good evening, Ghana. I simply love it.